I thought I'd demonstrate and remind you how to do your crow pose so that you can practice at home, and when we get back together, your crow pose is going to be strong. There's a few different steps. We can put our head on a block. We can also put our feet on this block. So to start off with, your hands are shoulder width apart. I'm going to demonstrate to have my knees around because that's the easier way. So knees around the arms. We could leave one foot on the floor, drop the head down to the block, take one foot off, and then slowly bring the other. But it's important to engage the legs. So engage the legs while pointing the toes. And then when you're ready, you can come off that and then drop back down. Another way is to actually be standing on that block, which helps lift your hips up high. Again, maybe the knees are around the arms. Arms are shoulder width apart. Chin this time is going to reach forward, so I'm going to look past that third point of energy. Maybe lift one foot off and then the other to slowly come back down. So that's with a block. You can also do crow pose with your knees on your arms. Again, chin forward. You can stand on that block again. One leg up and another. Point the toes, bring the heels towards the bottom to come back out of that. It's tiring, take your breath away. It's important to breathe, and I don't think I am. We can also take that into a baby crow pose by bringing your knees into your armpits, you bring your forearms towards the floor. So knees into the armpits, slide the forearms towards the floor, and then take the feet up. I like this one because you're not really far away from the floor. Okay, so it's you to play with. Now I'm saying,